2001, the World Trade Center was attacked. 2,996 people met to the immediate death. More than 6,000 people injured. 19 hijackers died in the attacks. $105 billion of economic loss of New York City. 56,000 people became jobless. 18,000 people were caught in the illness due to toxic dust. Above all, consequences took place just within 17 minutes. In 1945, in Germany, 60 lakhs Jew people were killed cruelly in the Holocaust. Out of them, 15 lakhs were innocent children. 72 million people met painful death in World War II. Around 17 lakhs years ago, Sitaji was kidnapped and harassed by a demon. The demon who had enmity with Lord Ram. The demon who had the battle with Lord Ram. Around 5,000 years ago, 18 Akshohini Sena, around 50 lakhs warriors met to the brutal death in the battle of Mahabharata. Lakhs of women became widows and lakhs of children became orphans. Number of innocent people became victims of tyranny. Can you tell me who were the people behind this biggest tyranny of the world? Actually, none of them needs introduction. Osama bin Laden, Adolf Hitler, Ravan, Duryodhan. But today my question to you is, why did they become responsible for the biggest tyranny of this world? Were they not educated? Were they not aware about what is right and what is wrong? Were they not skillful? Were they not powerful? Were they not creative? And do you know what was the education qualification of Osama bin Laden? Do you know what was the qualification of Adolf Hitler? Do you know what was the qualification of Ravan? You will shock. Ravan was the master scholar of four Vedas. And do you know how generous and diplomatic Duryodhan was? In spite of having knowledge, skills and powers, why did they become responsible for the biggest tyranny of the world? Why? What was missing in their life? The most missing factor was samskar, the values like gratitude, respect, compassion, empathy, integrity, forgiveness, truthfulness, non-violence, faith in God, devotion, and many more. In lack of such sanskar, they became the greatest tyrants of the world. Remember this conclusion, that education without sanskar and spirituality creates destructive results. Osama bin Laden was a highly intelligent person, highly educated person, but what his education gave to the society? Development or destruction? Betterment or betrayal? Education is blind without sanskar. Education is blind without sanskar. Sanskar gives right direction, right vision to the education. If you are a parent watching this video, then let me ask you this question. Do you want to see your child as a well-educated Laden or well-versed Ravan or well-educated human being along with culture and character? What kind of sanskar are you giving to your children? Ask this question to yourself. Just providing them food, clothes, money or education, is what our responsibility as a parent? If you believe so, then it's time to wake up. Let's come out from the illusion, because our scripture says that Pita na sasyat, Mata na sasyat, Guru na sasyat, Swajano na sasyat, Yo na mochayat samupet mrityum. He should not become a father, she should not become a mother, if they cannot give sanskar to their children. As a parent, our prime responsibility is to give sanskar to our children. Just imagine your child for a moment. What if your child is earning millions of rupees but not taking care of you and living in the old age homes? Is that okay for you? Will you be happy with that? What is the meaning of such education which doesn't inspire a person to serve his parents, society, and God? What is the meaning of such education which doesn't give real happiness and fulfillment in our life? That's not true education. Then what is true education? Our scripture says, Sa vidya ya vimuktai. That is the knowledge which liberates us from the miseries and sufferings. And that's not possible without sanskar and spirituality. But you know, sometimes people make the big mistake. They underestimate the role of sanskar and spirituality in our life. Sometimes they make fun of spiritual traditions, values, and religious rituals. And sometimes they totally ignore them. But they don't know that no person has ever become great in this world without sanskar, without values. You may take example of any great person in this world. As zero without a number has no value. Similarly, skills and knowledge without sanskar has no value. Today, let me share the ultimate formula for the success and happiness. That sanskar plus skill is equal to success and happiness. Here, sanskar represents number and skill represents zero. You can see the different combination of this formula. Sometimes mere skills can make you successful, but cannot make you happy without sanskar. And don't be in the illusion that more money, more wealth, more power, position, name, fame will make you happy. You will never face the face of happiness without sanskar and spirituality. But it's painful to say that nowadays sanskar and spirituality is shrinking in the society. Actually, in ancient time, around 9 lakhs gurukuls were there in our India. But by the time Britishers and Mughal invaders, they destroyed them to dominate and rule India. Since then, sanskar and spirituality is shrinking in the society. Who will protect our sanskar, culture, values, spirituality? This pain is the cause of Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul. This pain has brought Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul into the existence. But how? In 1948, this thought arose within the caring heart of great visionary saint Shastriji Maharaj Sri Dharmajivan Dasji Swami. How our future generation be without sanskar and spirituality? Wouldn't the world be otherwise in absence of sanskar, morals and spirituality? How to prevent this moral destruction? Shastriji Maharaj was lost in these thoughts and he was on the journey of pilgrimage in Himalaya. In the jungle of Badrinath around Rudraprayag, he saw a scene of an ancient Gurukul where a guru was teaching his students. At the very moment, Shastriji Maharaj got inspired and realized the words of Bhagavan Sri Swaminarayan. Pravartaniya Sadvidya Bhuvi Yatsu Krutam Mahat. Propagate true wisdom in the world is the most noble endeavor. It was a thought-provoking moment. Why can't we re-establish such a Gurukul system and preserve our sanskar, our tradition and spirituality? With this divine inspiration, Shastriji Maharaj came back to Gujarat Rajkot. And Shastriji Maharaj Sri Dharmajivan Dasji Swamiji established the first Gurukul at Rajkot on 11th May 1948, on Tuesday, on the auspicious day of Akshay Tritiya. And the name of this Gurukul was kept as Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul. Why this name, Swaminarayan Gurukul? Shastriji Maharaj was the founder of this Gurukul. He was the creator of this Gurukul. He could have kept his own name also, like Dharmajivan Gurukul. But Shastriji Maharaj didn't. Why? Because Shastriji Maharaj was having that great devotion for Bhagavan Swaminarayan, that if anybody would take the name of this Gurukul, that Swaminarayan Gurukul, indirectly he is chanting the auspicious name of God. Indirectly he is chanting Swaminarayan Mahamantra. His sins will get destroyed. He will get purified. He will come near to God and he will get salvation. Such was the emotion and devotion of Shastriji Maharaj behind keeping this name, Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul. And this proves the highest level of creditlessness and selflessness of Shastriji Maharaj. And today I am very much proud to say that Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul was the first Gurukul of independent India. And it was the biggest gift from Shastriji Maharaj to the whole world. And the Gurukul was started with only 7 students. But today, thousands of students are studying at a time in various branches of Gurukul worldwide. And number of students have acquired education with sanskar and spirituality in Gurukul, and they have moved into the society. Let me share you one small incident to understand why this Gurukul. Before the establishment of Gurukul, when Shastriji Maharaj was looking for the land, Shastriji Maharaj met Debarwar, a government officer from Saurashtra region, Gujarat. Debarwar asked to Shastriji Maharaj, "Swamiji, why do you need land? You are a sadhu, you are a sannyasi. What will you do with the land? Will you open a factory?" He said in the sense of humor. Shastriji Maharaj replied, "Debarwar, you are right. I want to establish a factory of manufacturing true human beings." Hearing the answer of Shastriji Maharaj and learning about the vision of Gurukul, Debarwar was impressed and inspired, and he granted the permission for the land. So Gurukul is not just a school, it's not just an educational organization. It's Gurukul. It's completely different from other schools and other organizations. Actually, Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul aims at teaching, training and transforming students and youth with Vidya, Sadvidya and Brahma Vidya. Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul strongly believes that without these 3 aspects, our life doesn't get fulfilled. These are the 3 aspects of life. Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul trains students for intelligent quotient, emotional quotient and spiritual quotient. Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul trains students for professional success, social and family success and spiritual success as well. With this unique value framework, Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul is transforming lives into the legends. Now, by the blessing of Guru Maharaj, Sri Dev Krishna Dasji Swamiji, and by the inspiration and spiritual guidance of Sadguru Sri Dev Prasad Dasji Swamiji, the Gurukul branches are spreading across the world. At present, there are Gurukul branches in almost all the mega cities of India, like Hyderabad, Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai, Rajkot, Surat, Ahmedabad, and many other cities in the various states of India. Apart from these, there are many branches in USA, UK, Australia, Canada, and still it's spreading over the world. Once you have joined Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul, as a student, as a parent, as a team member, as a volunteer, it's lifetime relationship and membership with the Gurukul. Actually, Gurukul exists for those who believe in sanskar, who believe in spirituality, who believe in God, who believe in salvation. If you believe in sanskar and spirituality more than education, then we, Sri Swaminarayan Gurukul organization, wholeheartedly welcome you in this mission of transforming life. So let's together transform the world with Vidya, Sadvidya and Brahma Vidya. Thank you. Jai Swaminarayan.